happy that I am honored to be here. Today I'm going to talk about challenge. Do you take challenge well?
Not sure well.
Not sure. How often do you take challenge?
Every day.
Every day. Good job, man. Anybody? Every day?
Yeah, maybe.
Every day? Wow, so good. How about once a month? How about once a year? Or you don't like challenge at all? Or you challenge others? That's another story. Okay. Challenge. Challenge is hard. Take on challenge is take on very hard stuff. A hard stuff make you feel so uncomfortable and you want to run away from that. Sometimes it could kill you too.
Yeah.
Right? Right? Okay. So I want to give you an example. You know, my job is to manage this language center. And we have a lot of teachers and we have a lot of administration staff here. Every time when I give them a new project, new task to do, their response is, "No, boss, I'm not very comfortable with that. I have too much work. I don't have time. Why don't you give it to someone else to do it?" Yeah, 99% of people say that. Yeah. But you know, there's two kinds of people I discovered. One is saying no, very beginning of the question. The other one is, let's say yes, take that as a challenge. And I discovered at the end of the year, the people who take that challenges is the people who grow the most, who got the highest KPI record, which is a performance appraisal, also got the most highest incentive bonus at the end. So my question to you is, do you see challenge is more like joyful stuff, or is more pressure for you? Howard?
Both.
Yeah.
Sort of both?
Both.
If you want to choose one, which is more?
It will be the joy after you complete or you overcome.
So first is pressure,
yeah.
And then after this joy,
right.
So sort of both. Yeah. Anybody want to answer that?
Maybe joy, because it will make me feel I'm alive.
Yes. Well, if you see, the challenge is the chance to grow, then you will enjoy the joys more.
Mm-hmm.
Your heart will see. Your heart will feel content here. So it depends on how you see it. Because each coin has two sides, right? And really depends on how you see the things. You want to take it as a pressure, as a burden, or as a joy to do it.
Right.
Another example for me is that a couple years ago, my boss criticized me and said, "Hey, Queenie, you're not doing very well in this language building. Your performance is not good. You cannot keep your team member stable because one or two team members left or transferred." And you cannot express yourself very well. So you have to think about it.
Right.
And I was so devastated. At that point of time, I was really like, the person in the whole world I care the most to say that I'm not good enough. Whoa, it's really like the end of the world. But at that point of time, I sit down and I say to myself, okay, I want to make it as an opportunity to grow. And I want to ask myself a lot of questions, make me feel much better. Yeah. So at that point of time, it happened that I joined Toastmaster. That's 4 years ago. So I see joining Toastmaster is my opportunity to grow. Yeah. So I try so hard to practice there. So my question to you before the workshop is that, what was your biggest challenge in Toastmasters? Right now here, okay? What's your biggest challenge? And how did you overcome it? If you did overcome it. If you didn't, that's fine. I would like you to since this is workshop, huh? Meaning that you have to work in this shop. So I want you to talk to your neighbor, tell them, give specific example, the answer. Okay, each person 1 minute. Okay, go. Neighbor,
talk.
2 minutes.
Namaste.